Hey there! Welcome to Life Noggin. Every day we're learning more and more about space and what's out there. I'm still hoping we find aliens one day. I think we're so close. But until then, we should try and learn more about what we know is already in our cosmic backyard. That big scary thing you humans call the sun seems like it could be pretty important. So here's my question. Should we send out a probe and go explore it? Well, first off, let's do an introduction. The sun may look like a giant flaming cheese puff, but it's actually a star that's made of extremely hot ionized gas called plasma. It's so warm that the temperature at the sun's core can be around 15 million degrees Celsius. That's almost as hot as my mixtape. I'm coming for you, Fred. Sorry, just a grudge I've been holding for a long time. The sun is not just super hot, but super big too. Its average diameter is around 1.39 million kilometers. If you want to feel super small, that's about 109 times the diameter of Earth. But why should we try and further study the sun? Well, some of the recent research from the National Academy of Sciences has a pretty compelling reason. According to their study, they estimated that without advanced warning, a huge solar storm could cause around $2 trillion in damage across the United States alone, and it could lead to widespread power outages for a long period of time. If learning more about the sun could potentially give us a way to warn ourselves, I'd say that's pretty important. Plus, studying the sun can help scientists learn more about how stars work, and it can even help us understand the rest of the universe. So are there plans of exploring the sun anytime soon? Yes, there are indeed. With their eyes set on later next year, NASA hopes to launch their Parker Solar Probe. This probe will go closer to the sun's surface than any spacecraft has before. Its mission will be to come as close as 6.2 million kilometers to the sun. That's within the orbit of Mercury.
I bet the other Roman gods will be so jealous.
On its journey, this space probe hopes to trace the flow of energy that warms and accelerates solar winds and the solar corona, explore what accelerates and transports energetic particles, and find out the structure and dynamics of the magnetic and plasma fields at the sources of solar wind. It sounds like a lot, but with this information, scientists hope that they will be able to more accurately predict space weather that could have huge negative effects on Earth. India also hopes to join in on the solar fun by launching their own satellite around 2019. Called the Aditya L1 mission, they hope to provide observations of the sun's photosphere, chromosphere, and corona. They want to achieve a better understanding of the dynamic processes of the sun and address outstanding issues in solar physics. I wish both of these teams the best of luck on their missions, because this stuff sounds really complicated. The sun is extremely important to our lives, but what effects would it have on your daily life and the Earth in general if it doubled in mass? If you want to know the answer, check out this video. If the sun were twice as massive as it is now, Earth would fall out of the habitable zone. Way out. First off, with more mass, the sun's luminosity, the amount of energy and brightness it gives off, would increase exponentially. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.